No, I'm not a timber geek, I'm just a regular guy.
In charge is project manager Daniel Niebeler.
I always wanted to build timber houses when I was a kid. So I started studying timber engineering and ended up as a project engineer for big scale glulam projects in the UK.
Glulam is short for glue laminated timber. The beams are formed of thousands of planks, glued together and cut to size.
We get spruce planks delivered from the sawmill and we put those into a kiln. And then we get dry down planks into our production line.
Workers scan each plank for imperfections that could create weak spots and remove those not up to scratch before gluing.
Glue will be applied onto several planks and then all the necessary planks required for one glulam beam will be put into a big press where they will be compressed till the resin has cured. It's immensely strong. The weight to strength ratio is bigger than with concrete.
Once dry, they cut and sand the beams down to size.
Well, this is actually already a proper glulam beam at the moment. It just has to be made good looking. Now the beams start to look really sexy. Oh yeah, we've got wood. Well, that's a top view of our Crossrail station roof. We could actually play Twister. Applying those steel parts onto the timber beams is the final step. All that's left afterwards is wrapping them up and put them on the truck over to London.
We're just about to put the centre section in place using the tower crane. We'll get everybody else out of the way and hopefully it'll go well. As you slew round, mate, that should stay same orientation. Heads up, heads up. Nice and steady, inches at a time, please, mate. Nice and steady, come down on your wire.
The keystone is in position, but it's not a perfect fit.
Just trying to locate the bolts on each corner. It's literally millimetres out.
The new station's roof is slowly taking shape. When complete, the entire building will be longer than its neighbour, One Canada Square, laid on its side.